It's Miss Kate back again with another super fun STEAM lesson for you this week. And in this activity today, we're going to be talking about buoyancy, and you guys are going to be constructing and designing your very own boat made out of tin foil. So let's get started. Alrighty, the challenge of making this boat is to design and build it so it can uphold the weight of as many pennies as possible. And your boat is only going to be made out of tin foil, so it's going to be a little tricky. So the first step in designing this boat is to take in consideration what makes a good boat. And to do that, you have to know about buoyancy. Alrighty, so let's talk a little bit more about what buoyancy is. Buoyancy is the force that pushes up on a boat in water, which allows it to float instead of sink. And there are two key things that make a boat buoyant, and that is its surface area and the stability of the boat. Now, the surface area is the measurement of the space the boat takes up. And the stability is how well the boat is constructed in correlation to it following its center of mass. So let's break that down a little bit more. So what this means is that the greater the surface area or more room the bottom of the boat takes up, the more buoyant forces are going to be able to push up on the boat. So having a greater surface area helps distribute weight within a boat. So keep that in mind when you're designing your boat to fit all the different pennies to help lift up the weight. However, you don't want too big of a surface area because then the boat will be unevenly distributed and become unstable and more likely to sink. Now, the stability of a boat depends on how the weight on the boat is distributed or spread out. The best way to understand this is imagine you're on a canoe with your friends and everyone in the boat tilts their body weight to the left. Now, the leaning causes the canoe to tip over to the left. The canoe tipped because instead of you and your friend's body weight being centered evenly in the middle of the boat, it was all moved to the left. Now this caused the center of mass and the weight to move also with it, and it became uneven and unstable. And that is why the canoe tipped over. So keep that in mind also when you're distributing those pennies out onto your boat. You don't want to put too much weight on either the left or the right side, but you want to make sure that they are evenly distributed between both. And that doesn't necessarily mean putting all the weight in the middle either. You want to make sure that all sides of your boat are evenly distributed so that the boat can remain stable. So there's a lot to keep in mind when considering making your own boat. You have to consider its buoyancy, the surface area, and the stability when designing and adding the weight to your boat creation. So let's get started on your boat creation. So for the supplies you're going to need today, you're going to need some tin foil, of course, because that is what we are going to be making our boat out of. You are also going to need some pennies or any loose change that you have laying around your house. For this activity, you may also like a scrap piece of paper or a notebook paper and a writing utensil so that you can map out and design your boat. And then when you are done with your boat, you are also going to need an area that you can test out your boat. So whether it's a sink, a bathtub, or just a bowl full of water, you are going to need some water to make sure that your boat can float. Alrighty, so after you have all your supplies collected, I want you to take the next couple minutes and think about and draw out a design for your boat. So I want you to consider the goal that you have for this boat and that you want it to accomplish is that you want to be able to keep your boat afloat and you want it to be able to hold up a decent amount of weight. So I want you to consider how much surface area you want your boat to take up and how you're going to be able to distribute and support the weight of all those pennies that you want your boat to hold. So make sure to keep that in mind and just take the next couple of minutes and create a design for your boat. Alrighty guys, so I have my plan for my boat all sketched out on just a scrap piece of paper I had laying around. And I just kind of drew out how big I wanted my boat to be, what my bottom of the boat I wanted it to look like, how I wanted the sides to be built up. And I also kind of marked off where I want to distribute the pennies on my boat. So I have them up here in the front of the boat, and I also wanted to put some on the back of the boat just to make sure that it was evenly distributed. So after you have the plan for your boat all done, you can go ahead and take your tin foil, and I just tore off a piece of it right here, and you can begin molding and designing and creating your boat out of your tin foil. So go ahead and do that, and then we will test out our creations. Okay, so my boat looks like it's floating really nice. So now what I'm gonna start doing is I'm gonna start adding in my pennies, and I'm gonna keep track of how many pennies I'm adding, and see how much weight my boat can hold up. So remember, when you're adding your pennies too, you wanna make sure that you're evenly distributing your pennies to remain that stability of your boat. So I'm gonna start counting and see how many I can hold up. Alrighty, so my boat got to 62 pennies before it wasn't able to float anymore. So go ahead and test out your boat. See if you can do better than mine. See if you can get to 70 pennies. Alrighty, another thing you can do too is you can go back to the drawing board with your boat. Maybe see if there's a different shape that works better, a different material that is stronger when building your boat. Really just try to make a goal for yourself of maybe doing 100 pennies and create a boat that can uphold the weight of that. So really just get really innovative with it and creative and have fun. Make it into a competition with your friends and family. Remember to have fun and be creative, and I will see you again next week. Bye!